All right, so I would ask y'all what the hell y'all are doing like I usually do, but I already know what y'all are doing. You're preparing to get silly with me. Let's go. All right, y'all, I know I've been gone for a minute, but now I am back. And since I've been gone for a minute, there have been a lot of things that have been happening in the news, a lot of crazy things, and I want to pick a few of them to talk about. Now, make sure that you're going over to patreon.com/AdrianExpression. This week was fun as usual. Podcast episodes, behind the scenes stuff. Also, the patrons got to tell me which topics they wanted me to talk about this week on YouTube. So yeah, check it out. Don't want to miss it. Also, my other channel, Avatar Adrian. The links for all of that are in my description box. Let's go. Y'all already know that there are crazy things happening all the time in the Atlanta airport. First of all, that airport is big as hell. If y'all don't split that airport up into two, I don't know what y'all got to do. Break that hoe up like a Kit Kat bar, because, bitch, it doesn't make no sense that I have to take a whole entire, train, trolley, whatever the fuck, to get to your, just to get to your gate. It'll make no sense. I have accepted that Atlanta airport is going to be the land of always winter, bitch. It's going to be full of White Walkers. It's because it's like you walk in there, it's zombie world. And bitches, first of all, we ain't happy to be here. Nobody happy to be here. Employees ain't happy to be here. It's zombies walking around. You know how sometimes it'd be like slow moving zombies in the movies, bitch? At Atlanta airport, it's fast moving zombies that gonna kill your ass, okay? You know what I'm saying? So tell me why. I saw this week, I guess last week, whatever. This woman was walking around. I don't know what happened. I don't know if she got pissed at the employees or something. This woman was walking around Atlanta airport spraying people with a fire extinguishers. Bitch, you would have swore that Zuko, Prince Fire Lord fucking Ozai, you would have swore that the Human Torch was in there saying, "Flame on! Why are you walking around Atlanta airport and fire extinguisher, girl? Get her!" And the people were just standing there watching her fucking do that shit. One of y'all hoes don't tackle her ass. Like, bitch, you could have sworn that it was, like, she thought she was Aang, bitch, coming to take vengeance against the Fire Nation for wiping out her whole people. This don't make no sense. These employees be at these airports just trying to make it through the day. Just trying to get y'all on y'all flies. Just trying to make sure that the pilot don't crash their shit. Like, they just trying to do their job. Y'all spraying these people who are not responsible for your flight being delayed or whatever it is. Y'all spraying these people with a fire extinguisher. Get y'all ass out of here. Don't make no sense. Don't make no sense that every single time you could count on Atlanta airport being absolutely ridiculous. Get her ass out of here. Arrested. Probably can't fly no more. For what? Just cause, for what? Cause it wasn't no fire, girl. Mamas thought she was Avatar The Last Airbender, bitch. Get me out of here. All right, now, so this headline, it's just funny to me because I don't care about, I do not care about Princess Diana jewels. You know what I mean? Princess Diana was a, she seemed like a very nice person, right? But as far as like expensive jewels, and for me, that's for people of those tax brackets to argue over. I don't care about y'all jewels unless y'all sell them to me and I can pay off some of these, what? Student loans. Y'all already know I was gonna say this shit. I don't care about them jewels. I just thought it was funny because Kim Kardashian said, "Y'all keep getting mad at me for stealing from black people, bitch. Guess what I'm gonna steal from next? I'm gonna steal from the crypt. I'm stealing from the fucking Grim Reaper, bitch." Kim Kardashian is now the owner of one of Princess Diana's precious jewels. So she apparently bought the amethyst and diamond Atala Cross. Girl, don't ask me the pronunciation of that bullshit. $197,453. The piece was worn by Diana on October 27th, 1987, when she attended some charity in London. We have to go to the memes and tweets that happened. Okay. Look at this one. I'm fucking crying. Bitch, for my House of the Dragon fans. Kim Kardashian is going to purchase you, bitches. Are you serious? Look at this shit. Promises, bitch. Are you serious? Kim Kardashian said, "Two niggas in my bed. Yeah, that's multiverses. I got moto when we flipping river." She said she's going to be taken on a trip through the multiverse, bitch. You heard what I'm saying? Y'all, I'm crying. Like I said, these expensive ass jewels are for people who have the coin to be arguing about that shit. I am not in a tax bracket to do that shit. I'm not. I don't really care. And honestly, there are a lot of people who are so pissed at Kim Kardashian for doing it. I just think it's hilarious. This shit is ridiculous. I think it's hilarious. There are a lot of people who are so pissed at Kim Kardashian. Oh my God, how could she buy it? Oh my God, she's buying it. It's like, girl, they are allowing her to buy it. Y'all, it's just like, if we really mad about something, we gotta stop the shit from happening. Y'all allow her ass to buy the shit. Nobody's really mad about the shit. People who are, like I said, people who are in that tax bracket don't seem to be pissed about that shit, because they $197,000 richer, right? They don't care. I don't care either. I just thought it was funny. Because, bitch, the only way, like I said, I give a fuck about no jewel like that is if you're selling it and putting that lump sum in one of my accounts, okay? I just wonder if anybody's going to be able to purchase any of Kim Kardashian's things whenever she, you know what I mean? Whenever she passes. Because it's just like, girl, do you even own any of the things that are in your house? Climate campaigner Greta Thunberg was detained alongside other activists on Tuesday during protests against a demolition of a village, I think in Germany, to make way for a coal mine expansion, but was released after some time, according to police. Now, this picture of Greta is just like, wow, imagine looking this cool while trying to prevent greedy motherfuckers from destroying this planet. Well, destroying it even further at this point. I guess the cops over there told her that if y'all come up here with that protest and shit, you're going to be escorted out of here by force, taken out of here by force, so. Greta was just like, okay, bad. I just thought that picture was like so cool. Yeah, I just remember thinking like one of these days it was like 70 degrees in December, you know, like recently, and I'm just like, wow, we finna be cooking on this house. We finna be cooking on this planet. That's all I'm gonna say. Anyway, speaking of Greta, let's talk about Andrew Tate, somebody who she dragged relentlessly. A judge in Romania has granted prosecutors another 30-day extension on the arrest of influencer Andrew Tate. I just remember seeing like a video of him talking about, oh, well, girl, that's why I go to Romania, countries like Romania, whatever, because their laws, I don't know if you're saying their laws are so lax or whatever. He was also saying like, oh, well, girl, if somebody try to lock me up, all I gotta do is hand him a bunch of money, hand him a bunch of money. And it's just like, it's looking like it's not working out for you, Andrew. The authorities allege that two of the suspects misled the victims into believing that they intended to enter into a marriage slash cohabitation relationship while transporting victims to Romania and later sexually exploiting them with physical violence and coercion. Authorities also said one of the suspects raped a victim on two separate occasions in March 2022, at least six victims were allegedly sexually exploited by the organized criminal group. As long as I see the headlines keep coming up, I'm going to continue mentioning this shit until he's out of here completely. Like, get his ass and people like him completely out of my face. Period. Let's talk about Ron DeSantis's annoying ass. Apparently, Ron DeSantis has banned the teaching of AP African American Studies in Florida. Now, backing up this argument, the state said the course framework for the study of reparations apparently includes no critical perspective or balancing opinion in this lesson. So, of course, many people argue like in order to have a nuanced or balanced discussion about these kinds of topics, you have to have one side that says that these people are oppressed and were oppressed and got fucked up by white supremacy, and you have to have another side that says that they fucking didn't. And it's just like, girl, that's not the slang that you think it is. We've heard a lot of arguments like this, right? When you state something that actually happened, like for example, the Holocaust or slavery, in order to have a balanced argument, people are saying that you have to have another person, another side to the argument that says that no, these things didn't happen. And it's just like, girl, I'm not gonna argue with you stupid bitches about whether or not the sky is fucking blue, girl. Period. They also objected to the study of the Black Power movement and the Black Panther Party because apparently the Black Panther Party was based on the ideology of Marxism, and the goal of the Black Panther Party was to fundamentally change and overthrow the American government. And it's just like, bitch, why y'all shaking y'all boots that people who are oppressed are saying, hey girl, and who have historically been oppressed are saying, hey girl, we are oppressed. that's all they're saying. Especially in school, all they're saying is like, these people went through this bullshit And historically have gone through this bullshit. They still going through certain bullshit and they oppressed. And that's it, that's all they saying. Y'all are shaking in y'all boots. And it's so apparent in the ways that y'all try to argue this shit away. It's not working, we see right through it. I just don't get it. Like, racists be so proud of being racist, they be proud of their racist actions, they be proud of discriminating against everybody who ain't them. Like, they just be proud of it until it's time to put it in the history books and look. Like, why y'all, if you're proud of it, and you are, cause y'all love to, you continue to be it and do it today, why y'all so mad when we just learn about it in the history books? Girl, this y'all, this is your handiwork. Like, what? Why you don't want people to learn about it? Girl, you want these kids, and I'm so glad that a lot of Gen Z just seem to be way smarter than that. You know what I mean? You want these kids to look at these demographics and be like, oh, so these demographics are mad, and you're raising their voice for no reason. Girl, get out of my face. Get out of my face. And speaking of Ron DeSantis, he was the one over here talking about don't say gay and signing all that shit into law. And I just find it interesting because this went viral, right? This video of this teacher talking about the fact that she got engaged recently.
I have this ring on my finger. Does anybody know why I would have this ring? What do you think, Cassidy?
Because you're married.
Because I'm married. Well, guess what? Over my break, friends, I got engaged. So that means that Miss Mackey's boyfriend asked me to marry him. And I thought that I would tell all of you.
And I love the video because at first you could tell that the kids are just like, okay girl, we're kids, we don't even know what you're talking about. Like, we don't even know what's going on. Like, okay girl, you got engaged, you got some shiny rock on your finger, like, okay, we're kids. But under don't say gay and all that shit, from my understanding, if she was lesbian, you know, showing off her partner, or if this was a gay guy showing off their partner or something like that, it would not be allowed. She could possibly be fired, I'm sure, whatever. Like, all types of crazy shit could happen. And it's just interesting, what is seen as pushing sexuality on the kids and grooming them and da da da, versus what is not. And it's just like, you can see, like I said, going back to the first point, is that even if you do show these kids, like, oh, this is my family, this is who I'm married to, blah, 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 they're gonna be like, okay. Okay, you know? So in the end, like, as you can see, Ron DeSantis, all these people, in the end, it's not about, cause they don't care about kids. Like we all know, they would've went after the fucking Catholics if they fucking did. Like, let's just be real about that shit. They don't care about kids, cause they would be concerned about LGBT youth dying by suicide, trans youth dying by suicide, they don't care about youth, right? This is just about making it illegal to even be LGBT, be trans specifically, you know what I mean? Like, even see them as people, humanizing LGBT people, all of that is off the table. That's their main goal. So don't let these people try and trick you into thinking they actually care about kids, bitch, because they would, first of all, they would be trying to make sure that free lunch is a reality for everybody, period. Y'all dropping bombs on hoes, y'all can give people free lunch. Get kids, your own kids, free lunch. Get out of my face. And last but not least, look at what the French are doing. Look at them cooking and grilling while they are striking. They are on, they're over there protesting, they're on strike, girl. This has come from BBC. More than a million people have joined a day of protests and strikes, according to France's interior ministry, against plans to push back the age of retirement from 62 to 64. There are about 80,000 protesters that took to the streets in Paris, with demonstrations in more than 200 French cities. President Macron, whatever it's called, the reforms just and responsible, but they are facing a make or break moment. The strikes severely disrupted public transport and many schools were closed. The main secondary education union said 65% of teachers were on strike, although the education ministry, the official like number said it was 35. The unions over there have condemned this measure to try and raise the retirement age. The worst outcome for the government could be rolling strikes in transport, hospitals, and fuel depots, effectively bringing the country to a standstill. So it's like the girls are over there, they are, the girls over there in France, girl, I mean, I know that there are probably all types of issues that I'm not privy to just because I'm not a citizen over there, but it's just very interesting to see that they do not give a fuck. They're over there grilling on the railroads. They say, bitch, we're not going to work. We're not going to be moving these vehicles around, but what we are going to be moving on these tracks are some grills, bitch. We're going to be making some food, okay? it is so interesting to see them get up and shake the foundations of Paris every time something happens. I'm like, bitch, we need to do that shit. We need to be doing that shit. We need to be doing that shit. But anyway, y'all, that's what's been going on, at least for the week that I kind of took off a little bit. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you support on Patreon and get your extra content and weekly podcasts on patreon.com/AdrianExpression. Check my description for all the links to everything. Love y'all so much. Like I said, and make sure that you have a good goddamn evening. You can blow me, I ain't the only, you so lonely, insecure, dick don't control me. I ain't the